without taking it in grain, water even, always here, very efficient. No disturbance of mind. And here. Intimately, I want to ask you a question. Is my Bharat Prabhu is here? You know all Mahabharat. That is why your Guru Dev gave you your name, Mahi Bharat. You can answer. Can you answer that? What was the effect of Battle of Mahabharat? When both parties, all the prominent heroes were killed, only five Pandavas, Krishna, and three in Kripacharya, Ashwasthama, and Kritapacharya were left. All the weapons, Dhanurvidya, archery, also, all the ladies became. So, really, what was the effect of this Mahabharata? You should tell very brief.
One effect, Maharaj, was that Krishna eliminated the Kshatriyas who were overburdening the earth. The other effect is that he reinstalled King Yudhisthira as the emperor of the planet.
Okay, anything else? Why Krishna came to this world? There is a promise in Srimad Bhagavad Gita and also in Vedas, paritranaya sadhuna, vinashaya dushya, dharma sansthapana, sambhava nija. Was it established by Mahabharata battle? Was not.
First two things were done.
Was it established?
Krishna has come to establish
Dharma.
Yuga-dharma. No? Paritranaya, Gita, in Gita is Paritranaya sadhunam vinashaya cha duskritam. By doing two things, to establish Dharma. Was it established by this battle? Was not.
No. Krishna also spoke Bhagavad Gita on the battlefield.
Really, it was established. All the demons was only false ego and hero and so intelligence. Fighting each other, not following real Atma Dharma. We are all eternally servant of Krishna. Kamsa, Jarasandha, Duryodhana is all associates. We are denying this fact. So Krishna killed all the demons. And after that, what became? What Krishna has come to do in this world? To love each other. Even to love creepers. No? Krishna used to love creepers also. Creepers also. Deers, animals, trees. These used to bend in the Lord's feet of Krishna and give them Patanjali in the lotus feet of Krishna. So after Mahabharata battle, after 300 years after, first sitting of Srimad Bhagavat was there. Even that day, Srimad Bhagavat was not preached. But after 300 years, Krishna left this world. His associate left. Mahabharata battle was done. And then a time came to preach Srimad Bhagavatam. This was the aim and object of Mahabharata battle, that this should be preached Srimad Bhagavatam. What is Srimad Bhagavatam? Love and affection to Krishna. Parikshit Maharaj was there. Sukadeva Goswami came. And he told this thing. After 200 more, after that, Dhundukari and Gopal went there. Again, second, what?
Elevation
means?
Recitation of Bhagavad.
Recitation?
Yeah. No, session of Bhagavad.
Session of Bhagavad. Hell. And third, when Bhakti Devi became old with his two sons, and Narad went to his elder brothers, Sanat Kumar, four Sanat Kumar, and he told that all should listen to Srimad Bhagavatam. All the problems for all human beings, all
entities,
for all times, all will be solved by this, by hearing and by following Srimad Bhagavatam. At the time of Mahabharata, before Mahabharata, they had no time to hear Srimad Bhagavatam. All were badly engaged in sense gratifications and fighting each other like demons. So at that time, there was no time to hear Srimad Bhagavatam. But all the demons like Karna, Shakuni, Dushasan, Jarasandha and Pandrik Vasudev, all were killed. Now there was a peaceful time. Is there any God or not? Who is controlling this world? Who is managing whole world? From where this world came? And why all problems coming? And then Srimad Bhakti Devi at once became so. Ron, his sons, Jan and Baran also came. And there was peaceful for some time. And then Srimad Bhagavatam preached over everywhere. Especially Chaitanya Mahaprabhu came. He was the embodiment of Srimad Bhagavatam. That is embodiment of Radha and Krishna both together. And he came only to give love and affection for all. In any way, all the conditioned souls, they have this like a seed in them. And that is why Krishna and his Jesus came in this world. Before Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, there was bhakti, there was love something, but not so developed. There were also so many sampradaya acharya like Madhva, Ramanuja, Tyas, Vishnu Swami, Vallabha Acharya. Oh, they propagated these things. But not like a bhakti rush and so high like Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and he associated. Sprinkle their mercy. At that time, Narada was there before battle of Mahabharata. But no one was listening to him. But when Mahabharata
finished,
and then the whole world he was. Now he had changed something. He has kept Veena. And now he has taken Mridanga and Kartal with him. And everywhere in the world, when we are not realizing this. In any shape, in any guru, Narada Maharaj was expressing all these things. So there was a good result of Baba. Sometimes wars, great wars are necessary for these demons. They become like plant. They want to destroy the whole world, but they cannot do anything. Now I am coming to my subject. Always you should know that Krishna will always manage this world. Always is controlled. No one other. Even Brahma cannot do. Even Mahavishnu to control is very difficult. But Krishna can control. All he can control Brahma, Mahesh, Shankar and all. Now, before the birth of Krishna, you know that how Parikshit Maharaj is disturbed. Don't do that. So when Krishna had not appeared in this world, this prithivi, the earth, was feeling so much disturbance. He can have a load of all world, but she becomes upset when the person having so false ego, thinking that I am this body, quarreling each other, doing so many bad activities like Duryodhan was doing with Draupadi and all others, then earth becomes so always worried. She went to demigods. Because demigods sometimes look over all this world to maintain peace and all everything. But they could not do anything. So they all went to Shankar, and taking Shankar, they went to Brahma. And Brahma took them and went to Kshirasamudra. And he began to pray in trance. Hearing his trance, his worshipable, Garbhodha Sai Vishnu, he told in sky,
aerial voice,
like that, that my Prabhu has known that world is now suffering. This is Prabhu of Garbhodha Sai Vishnu. Who is Prabhu? Krishna himself. He has known. And quickly he will come. At once you should go and take your birth in Jadav family and tell your wives to go and to take birth there to serve Krishna Priya. All demigods to serve Krishna and their wives to serve Srimati Radhika. Quickly you should go. And he is coming. And then they returned and they began to take birth there. After some time, Vasudeva. After marriage, he was sitting on the chariot, taking the reins of horses, and loving her younger sister. Devaki. He was carrying. In the meantime, again,
a voice
came from the sky that a foolish person, you don't know that the child of this Devaki will kill you. Hearing this, he became violent. And he took a sword in his right hand. And by left hand he took the and wanted to kill him. But Vasudeva was so intelligent and he was so sahishnu. If anyone has no tolerance, he cannot do bhajan of Krishna. Never. So whether renounced person, brahmacharis or krihastha, this should be very tolerant, like Prahlad Maharaj, like Srinivasa Acharya. You saw that his son was dead, even chanting. So tolerance is necessary. Jena dapi suni chena, tarorapi sahi sunana, amanina manudena, kirtani yasutana. If anyone chanting and remembering Krishna name and his pastime, but if he is not following tina dapi suni chena this shlok, then he is really not Vaishnava. Sometimes we misguide in this. Anyone chanting these Tulsi words, chanting Hare Krishna, oh, we should think that, oh, he is Vaishnava. And when quarrels, have false egos, and doing nothing, chanting, living chanting, oh, he was Vaishnava, but he has left. I think he was never Vaishnava, and he never left. Only formality will not do. We should try to recognize Vaishnava. Agraha mukti, tabe sabrabandhanas, tabe sahishne pare Vaishnava das. If anyone has not like that, he has attachment, but the attachment, lacks and lacks desires, always quarreling for worldly things, he cannot be doing. Outwardly taking mala, and this will not do. So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu told to Raya Ramananda Sarup Damodar, in what process we should take and chant him, that being a devotee, we will attain Pre Krishna. Then he told, this is true. He told, Sarup Ram Rai, Ki Upa Laile Naam Prem Upajar. In what process we will should try to take chanting them? Then we will be a real devotee and Krishna Prem will return. Easy. Oh, then he told, if anyone devotee, following this slok, Dina tapi suni chena tarurupi sahi suna mani na mante kirti musaya. He can follow them. Never. If outwardly he is falling down like Bharat Maharaj, like Chetra Ketu Maharaj, it is for teaching to us. Not so, Vasudeva was like that. What is the meaning of Vasudeva? Where Krishna takes rest. He is Suddha Sattva. When we'll go in the stage of Bhav Rati, then this Suddha Sattva will come to our heart. And Krishna will take his heart. And pure name will be at in that stage. So, he was so intelligent. So he told so many things. Why you are disturbed by this? She is your younger sister, like your daughter. Why you are going to kill her? Do you believe in that aerial fires? Yes. He thought, Vasudeva Maharaj, he is a demon. He is half believing and half not believing. If the aerial sound has told that you will be killed, then he will be must killed. Why all do experiences? So, Vasudeva Maharaj has this very strong faith that he cannot kill Devaki. And because 8 sons will come and he will kill Kama, surely. Anyhow, I should be any nimitta.
Cause.
He cannot do anything. So he wanted to do something. He told them, if this sun, eight sun will be burned, I will give to you. Oh, I want to give my all childs. And first child he gave. Then he became very happy. And he returned, let go. You are very true person. I believe in you. So when that sun will come, you can go. But in the meantime, Narada came. What you are doing? Oh, you are my very dear disciple. But you are doing nonsense. Don't do like this. If you are returning all these sons, then they will be very
grow up
and very strong, and then seven this and that one. They will easily kill you. You should not. And demigods are very intelligent and tricky. If they will count from second, then who will come eight?
First will be.
So, which is first and which is last, which is eight, which is six, it is no certain. So, if first will be counting from second, then this will be eight, and he will kill you. Why he did so? He was very, very much worried for Krishna. He was always waiting for Krishna. When will you come? And he knew everything, past, present and future. And if Kansi is not doing more bad things, then it may be day of Krishna coming. So he was. And he knows that Atma is Ajaravar. Soul is
immortal.
And he can. By this doing, Krishna will help them to be transcendental. Any very rare devotee can realize this. So here, after telling Kans, Narada Rishi went, and he went to again to Vasudeva Maharaj. You should try to he told that you should try to a son will be and which will kill Kansa. So you should try to support and nourish him very well. I'm going. He was friend of both. No Shatru. If there was no Kans, no pastimes of these all Krishnas. So someone realized the mercy of Narada Rishi. And after that, one by one, six sons were killed by Kans. And then Shankarsan came in the womb of Devaki. By Jog Maya, he was taken to the womb of and then first came Baladev Prabhu. Malli 15 days before.
8 days.
Krishna came, Baladev came on Purnima. And Krishna came on Ashtami. Only there were difference of 8 days between them. And that is why they are always, after birth, they are playing together. Their name, ceremony was done in same day. They were like all friends. So both were there. After that, Krishna came in the eighth temple.
This is another question of, I think, Rikin Maharaj. Why Baladev?
Yes. So, this question was answered. That first he came in the womb of Devaki. And 6 months he was there. And in 7 months, he was transferred by Jog Maya. In the womb of
Rohini.
In Rohini Garbh, Baladev was there from before, for 6 months waiting. And this went there. And this, the Devkishan,
And Vasudeva's son. No. The son of Devaki was part Krishna. He was Vishnu or Narayan, Narayan Tattva. So this Baldev of Devaki was mixed in the Rohini Om with Baladev there. He was present there. And after, again, 6 months or 14 year, months, Baldev took this path. And after after 8 days, Krishna came in the Om of Deva, partly. And he came full in the Om of Yashoda Maya, with Yoga Maya there. Anyone could not know this mystery. Yoga Maya knew. After that, when Krishna took birth in the prison of Kanskaragar, in the prison of Kansh, he was 400. Age about 60. Very young. Very beautiful. Hair so long, long, curved. Golden ornament. Like Sri Vatsa. Here also. Shankar Chakra Vadala. A son does not come like this. So Krishna appears. As he appeared from the pillar, Nishinghade, he appeared there, but not like a son by Om. But he appeared there partly, like Mahavishnu or Narayana. And then when he appeared, Vasudeva and Devaki began to pray. Oh, you are himself, the supreme personality of all things. Krishna told, yes, I am the same. So long before, you were Prishni Garbha, Devaki, and Vasudev Sutapa. And you were praying, you are doing so much hard austerities. More than 60,000 years. Standing on this toe, feet up, not taking air and water anything. And then I appeared in the same. I told that you should have any benediction. You both told that we want a son like you. Then I told there is none equal to me. Asamordha tattva. There is none. So I must have to come like your son. And when he heard, then they began to more doing prayers and prayers. After that, Krishna told that you should keep me where? I'm becoming like a boy. And take me to Gokul. And there, a daughter of Nanda Baba is there, Yashoda, and you should obey. But what became? When Krishna here in 400 he appeared, and there also in Gokul, Krishna came at the same time, in full. And like a baby, here is Janma Leela, the pastime of coming in Om, coming from Om. And after some time, a baby also, lady baby.
Natural birth of a child.
And also after that, 5 minutes or 10 minutes or 15 minutes after that, Yoga Maya came. Like a girl. So both were there. A son and a daughter there. When Vasudev prayed that, I want that you should be a child. Then I will obey your orders and I will take it too. In the same time, Krishna became like a child. And At the same time, Krishna in Gokul, he came here and took that 400.
He converted from 400 to.
And he took
in him.
In him. And then only child was there. No 400. And quickly he took it there. And he kept there. And he took. But here, it has been told in Srimad Bhagavatam, Sukadeva Goswami is telling that Krishna was born in Mathura and he took it to Gokul and he brought a daughter from there, their daughters, and he exchanged. But we see that next day, Nandastu Atmaja Utapanne. Sukadeva Goswami first told that Krishna came from Vasudev and Devaki. Why he is telling? That he knew that Parikshit Maharaj in the dynasty of relating to Krishna, Vasudev Nanda. And he will be happy that he is doing everything. He has gone to Vrindavan, he has played all these things. Again he came to Mathura, again he went to to please king. But he was hiding something there. It is true that Krishna is son of Vasudeva. But partly, with opulence, Narayan is like there. But Nandanandan is supreme personality of Godhead. Krishna stu Bhagavan Swayam. And that, who is he? That Krishna is there. Also, he has told, when he came, Vasudeva returned, taking a baby girl, and automatically, the doors were closed. The Hathakadi and Bedi, chains were locked in their hands and feet. And all guards, they woke up. And they heard a voice of weeping a girl. At once they went to Kans. Kans at once came and wanted to kill this girl. Vasudeva and Devaki were praying him that don't do so. But he was not a person to listen. He took his heartbeat and he wanted to keep like this that she should be smashed into pieces. But in the meantime, she went above in this way. And he became Ashtabhuja.
800.
And so many weapons. And he was riding on a wine. And told her, oh, Kans, what can you do? And he gave some kick from here. And he became. He was upset and he was rolling down on the earth. He was saying that he is Griha Devata, family worshipable. And he he began to do so many prayers. She told that, your enemy has taken birth already. You cannot do anything to him. And she vanished. Here, Sukadeva Goswami now, he is telling, Adrishat Anuja Vishnu. When Kans was doing like this, and he came out from his hand and went to his sky, Adrishyata means disappeared. Who disappeared? This sister of Vishnu, and this Krishna. How he became this sister of Krishna? In jail of Kans, only Krishna was there, no daughter there. So Jogmaya is not sister of Krishna by this relation. How it becomes? If Krishna and that Jogmaya coming from the womb of Jashoda Maya, then they can be brother and sister. So here is point. Because in Mahabharata, Khil Hari Gansh, it has written that Jashoda yielded two son and one daughter. And they were mixed, that son in Krishna. So, after that, Nakhal Gopika Nandanu Bhaman. Any Brajvasi cannot tell that he is the son of Vasudeva. Never. Even trees, creepers, what to tell of human? Gopi Gopi will never. I want to say that if Mathura Vasi are telling something and Brajvasi are telling something, which is true and to whom we should believe? Mathura Vasi always tells lie. Srimad Bhagavat Vishwanath Chakravarti Gita Srimad Bhagavat Krishna has told. Arjun told that I don't believe you. Then he told that, oh, na me bhakta pranasyati, you should promise. You should get. I will not. Because I may change my view. Because I am Mathura Vasi. Because who Krishna was in Kurukshetra, he was from Mathura, from Devaki, not Krishna that. So, gopis are telling, Nakhal Gopika Anandana Bhavan, Akhila Dehinam Antradatmadi, Vikhan Sartito, Vishwa Guptaye, Sakhi Budhiyaman. Oh, you are surely the son of Yashoda Maiya. Yashoda Maiya is so merciful. But you are not merciful, why? You must be merciful like Yashoda Maiya. So you should appear here and meet us. Also, Jayatite Dhika Janmana Praja. Who is telling? Vyas Dev is telling. Narada is telling. Brahma is telling. Sukhdev Goswami is telling. Sukhdev Goswami only repeating their words. Jayatite Dhikam Janmana Praja. Press should be so glorious, so glorious. Why? Because when Krishna took birth in Vrindavan, Brajabhuvi, in Gokul, then Lakshmi used to bring everywhere to decorate. Like a dasi, like a maid servant. So here also, Janmana Braja is very prominent. Also, Gopis are telling to Katyayani, no? What that? Katyayani, Mahamaye, Mahajoganadhishwari, Nanda Gopasutam Patime Kurute. What they are praying? We want that the son of Nanda Baba should our husband. Then Katyayani, yes. Krishna came and he, instead of Jogamaya, Jogamaya never came, Katyayani never came. Krishna himself came and benefited them. So, he is a Nanda Sutta. Putri Bhute Janardane. Putri Bhute Janardane. Also, in Srimad Bhagavati. When Krishna will be your son, Devaki and Vasudeva. Nanda Sunu, I am Artha Jananam. All the gopis are praying to Krishna. Nanda Sunu, I am Artha Jananam. Narmado Jarahi Kujitabe. That you are Nanda Sutta. Tava Sutta. Tati Jadadhar Bimbe. Nanda Sunu, Anukhe Tava Vasu. Also they are praying that. So many people. Also, Devaki Janma Bhado, partly the son of Devaki, not solely and whole. So when Sukadeva Goswami is telling to please Parikshit, but when he is absorbed in telling Harikatha, then he forgets to please Also Brahma, our guru, first guru, he is telling, Namaidhyate abrapapushe taditambaraya gunja vatansa paripachal sanmukhaya vannasraje kavala petra pishanu venu vidupaje pasupangaja. Pasupanga, pasup means gavi, gaya, go, pasup. And who is supporting and nursing and serving the cows is Pasupa Nanda Baba. And his putra is Pasupa Angajaya from Jasoda Om Krishna. When this festival was going, there was some link with Mother Jasoda and that was cut. But this was not done. So, Swamiji has also written like this. He first has told anywhere that he was the son of Vasudeva and Devaki. And then his adopted son of Vasudeva. But when all this he adopted that Krishna is the son of Nanda and Yashoda. So we should try to realize all these things. Then
Brijavasi never knew that her daughter was also born.
Yes. They never knew. Never. After this, next day, after 2 days after the birth of Putana came in. And Nanda Maharaj at that time has went to Mathura to pay some toll tax to
Kamsa.
And in the meantime, in the night, Putana came and tried to kill Krishna in the shape of mother. By very powerful. But Krishna took his pran also, life, soul, and everything, and gave him the gati of mother. How he is so much merciful, Krishna. After that, he began to tell how Sakatasha was killed, how Trinavat was killed, what are these things? How a demon can come in Vrindavan? It is impossible. When all the trees in Vrindavan, all the cows, all are transcendental, the place Vrindavan is transcendental place. How a demon can come? To renew the love and affection of Yashoda Maiya Parijavasi to Krishna. How? I will explain all these things. Now, a Kirtan Sutta. Namami Nandana. Also,
thank you.
When Bamandev came as a boy, he was so beautiful, so charming. So daughter of Bali named
Ratnamala.
She thought in her heart, I want a son like this. Very beautiful, very
lovely.
Bamandev knew it. And when she saw that he is cheating my father, being so tall, and he took everything, then she became very furious. Oh, if you will be my son, then I will poison you, and I want to kill you. So, Krishna, Bamandev, oh yes, you will have to do all these things. So, in Krishna, this pastime, she became Putana, like a sister of Kamsa. And he came in Jashoda Bhavan, and she took a vase, shape of mother, very lovely mother. By yoga means?
Mystic power.
She took a shape of very lovely mother. At the age of 124, so beautiful. And she was so having so many golden ornaments, very lovely, smiling. Jashoda thought, and the Rohini Devi, oh, she has come from
heavenly planet.
She's like angels. And he's actually mother. I'm not mother. I'm not qualified. Not so beautiful as she is. And very lovely. Oh, my dear son, why you are sleeping on the bed? You should sleep in my and taking Krishna, very beautiful. and cure, correction. And he gave his. But Krishna was thinking, what should I do? He closed his eyes. Very trickly. He took his life and soul and everything. Poison cannot do him anything. That poison became nectar. And he took her life. Why? By this shape, she cannot come to me. So this body is rotten and full of so many egos and so many things. So he destroyed. And she became like mother, eternal mother in Golok Vrindavan. And Krishna sent her. Very easy. Ahopakiyam stanakalakutam. Always she was taking the flesh and blood of very little boys. He was trying to act like hen, a channel. Like that, right? She used to take the and drink the bloods, fresh bloods of little babies. He intended braja. But who child she was taking? Only demons. She could not see any devotion in Bhagavad Gita is written. Those who were so much against Krishna and their friends of Krishna and their child also will be like that. So he and so Krishna is so merciful that anyone, if a link like mother and telling Krishna, oh my dear son, at once he can. So if he will think that we are beloved of Krishna, oh Krishna beloved, oh my son Krishna, this son you will, the relation will be there, then Krishna quickly will be so merciful to take us to Golok Vrindavan for eternal service. This is not imagination, not only the sentiment of this world, not nothing. It is true of real. Even today we can see all these things. So, Krishna is so merciful. So, living Krishna, who will be this so intelligent to serve all others? Demigods or anything else. So, we should try to love Krishna with this relation. What is that initiation? Initiation when Guru gives any transcendental relation and there is some relation, Guru only manifests. If anyone not realizing this, real renunciation has not been done. Only he was admitted to for this, but he could not. So Swamiji has come. All Goswamis and all the Guru Parampara has come only to gain these things. We are all eternal servants and we are related to Krishna. Gaur Brahma. Very quickly.
Very of Lord Shiva. I hope this will be pleasing all, especially Gurudev, and we have one song here by Tapana Mishra. Play one while the drama is just getting ready to come in. We have this one song. Thank you.
Song I've written in Gaur Confession, Sri Maharaj. This is the song to play on the Kali. Oh, if the drummers could play in the Maha Mantra. Thank you. Gurudev is on the road, bringing Krishna to us all. Gurudev is on the road, trying to help us to recall. Gurudev is on the road, bringing Krishna to us all. Don't you know that you're on your spirit soul? You know you are, you are, you are, that you're on your spirit soul. You know you are, you are. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Gurudev is on the road, bringing Krishna to the song. Is wrong, our minds he doesn't throw, and when you ask, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare.
Thank you. The drama will be right here. One quick announcement. Tonight at 8:30, because Prasad was coming so late, mothers and children can take in the garage.
Yes.
I want blessings. I want benedictions. I want power. And whoever will give me what I want, I will serve. But who will give me what I want? Brahma is powerful. Maybe I should offer my prayers to him. Lord Vishnu is also powerful. And so is Lord Shiva. Who should I pray to? Great sage, one who knows all, please, would you help me? I have a request to ask of you.
Yes, what is it that you need?
I want benedictions by performing austerities, but I want it fast. I want quick results. Who should I pray to? Brahma, Vishnu, or Shiva?
His mind is very demoniac. He is a very evil person. His plan must be terrible. You should go to Lord Shiva and worship him. He is very easily satisfied.
Good.
Many personalities, such as Banasura and Ravana, who have personalities like yours, they have. On
to please you, oh Lord Shiva, I offer you something oh so dear to me, my own flesh. I hereby give to you. Please accept this offering. Please come now so that I may get from you my heart's desire. Come quickly, O Lord! Come soon! Come now! For days and days, if I keep offering my flesh, I'll soon be dead.
His bath in a nearby lake. Then, without drying his body or his head, he prepared to cut off his own head.
Oh.
What are you doing? This is not the way to satisfy me, by cutting your own head?
Oh, you've come. Oh, my lord, but you did not come when the offering was my own flesh. So of course I had to cut off my head and offer it to the fire.
I am very easily pleased by the simple worship of Gunga water and bilba leaves. So I am very, it's a simple process of pleasing me. If you want to please me, then there's no need to cut your flesh and offer it to the fire. Anyway, never mind. You have attracted my attention. And I will give you whatever you want.
Yes. Anything! Anything!
Yes. But I want you to think a while. It is very important that you think about this, because a benediction received by me can do great good for the entire universe. So you choose your desire to be fulfilled very carefully and wisely.
I've decided. I know what I want. I want such power that as soon as I touch someone's head, that head will immediately explode and he will die!
Oh! How horrible!
And then I will become immortal by killing everyone else! And then I will enjoy my life!
I am sorry I offered you this wicked desire. But I have promised, and therefore I will not withdraw it.
In the first person, I will enjoy using your kind benediction will be your wife, Parvati! And the first person I will kill will be you, Lord Shiva!
Lord Shiva began to flee. He fled from the land to the sky, and from the sky to the other planets. He fled until he reached the limits of the universe. From one place to another, the demon Vrikashur chased Lord Shiva. Even the controlling deities like Indra. And Brahma. They could not uncover any way to save Lord Shiva. At last, Lord Shiva approached Lord Vishnu, who lives on the planet known as Shwetadweep. As soon as Lord Vishnu realized that Lord Shiva was in grave danger, he appeared as a young Shivite brahmachari and waited on the path for the demon.
Welcome, Vrikasura. You appear to be very tired.
Yes. Yes, I am very tired. I have been traveling all over the universe, chasing Lord Shiva.
Oh, and your traveling seems to have ended here. You have come so far, so fast. I think you should take a rest. It's not good to place great strain and stress on your body. Remember the value of the body. For in this body, you can fulfill all the desires of your mind.
But I am in a very great hurry. I must go immediately.
Oh, son of Sukuni, relax. You are Sukuni's son, aren't you?
Yes, Sukuni is my father. You know my family, dear Brahmachari?
Oh, yes, I know Sukuni very well. Vrikasura?
Yes?
Remember what I said about the importance of the body? Your body? Please take my words very seriously and carefully.
Yes, you're right. I must take good care of my body, for I need it for my plans. And I have lots of plans, very enjoyable plans.
My dear Lord?
Me, Lord? Who are you talking to?
You, of course, O son of Sukuni. Now, tell me of your mission and why you have come here, and I will be very happy to help you.
Your words are very sweet, my friend. And by your speaking, you have given new energy to my tired body. I, great effort, received a benediction from Lord Shiva.
Thank you.